Hi guys, how's it going? Welcome back to my channel. Today's video I'm very excited for because I have been meaning to do this for a little while and kind of just getting around to it now. We're gonna be doing a minimalist wardrobe challenge. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of Project 333. That's what we're up to. So if you're unfamiliar with Project 333, I'm just gonna give you a quick little lowdown and then I'm gonna get into pulling some pieces from my own wardrobe and I am gonna partake in this challenge for 1 month. I'm gonna try it out for 1 month and just see how it goes. And I think it'll actually be a lot easier since the weather is warmer and you don't need as many layers. So I'm really interested to see how it goes. So basically Project 333 is, like I said, it's a minimalist wardrobe. It was created by a girl named Courtney Carver. I'm gonna leave the details down below if you're interested in finding out more. She wrote a book on this little challenge and it's changed a lot of people's lives, a lot of people's mindsets on their wardrobe, and just really helped people hone down on that more minimalistic wardrobe that works for them. So basically what it is you're gonna take 33 pieces from your wardrobe for 3 months. All you're gonna do is wear those 33 items, nothing else. That's why it's called 333. 33 pieces in 3 months. So those 33 items, it has to include all of your accessories, your jewelry, your outerwear, your shoes. All of that counts towards the 33 things. What doesn't count toward the 33 things is things like your underwear, your sleepwear, your loungewear, you know, things that you would just be in around the house. So it's basically geared towards like your wardrobe for when you're going out and about or for when you're going to work. It's that sort of thing. So what I'm gonna do is head to my wardrobe. I'm gonna pick out my 33 pieces with you guys and then go over each piece and sort of why I picked it really quickly. And then I think after the month is over, what I'll do is a full update and I'll show you guys like the outfits that I was creating with all of these pieces. And it should be a little bit of a challenge, a fun challenge that I'm like ready to take on. So I'm gonna be doing this challenge sort of in my everyday life because of course I still wanna be creating fashion content for you guys. So while I'm creating videos over the month, you might see pieces that were not in my Project 333, but at the end of the month, I will be doing a full update with outfits that I've put together with these 33 pieces. So I have just cleared off my clothing rack here. So basically what I'm gonna do is run to my wardrobe and sort of just grab the 33 pieces that I want to use for this little challenge. And they're gonna lie right here. That way I'm not mixing other things into it. I know what my 33 pieces are and it's gonna be a lot easier to work with. So if you guys are doing this at home, what I would suggest if you don't have like an extra clothing rack, maybe take like a ribbon or just something like that that you can separate at a certain point in your wardrobe and put the items that you want to use in the challenge on one side and then have everything else sitting on the other side. That way you know not to touch anything over here, but anything on this side of the ribbon is good to go. All right, so I've just finished pulling the 33 items from my wardrobe. Now this was easier than I thought, but also kind of tricky. Like it was more pieces than I thought. Like I know it's 33 pieces, but when I started pulling pieces and counting them, I was like, oh, okay. Like there's definitely room here. We can pick a good amount of pieces and be able to mix and match outfits. So that's kind of what I was thinking while I was pulling pieces. What can I mix and match in a lot of different ways and get a lot of different outfit combinations with? So with that being said, I'm gonna show you guys exactly what I picked. And I'm going to be leaving like all of this stuff in my little den, my office room, so that it's separate from the rest of my wardrobe and I know that these are the pieces that I have to pull from. All right, so we're gonna get started with the accessories. So remember, accessories are included in the 33 items, accessories, shoes, bags, it's all gotta be there. So number one is gonna be these earrings right here. I love just a very simple pair of gold hoops and I think they just add to any outfit. So these are the only pair of earrings that I have selected. I ended up going for more clothing and then a little bit more minimal with the shoes, bags, and accessories. So one is the earrings, then we have two I love this little evil eye necklace, and 3, because these two I like to layer up together or I can just wear them separately. Number 4 would be my sunglasses. These are probably my favorite pair. 5 is this chunky chain necklace. Number 6, we have cognac brown bag. We have a summer bag and then a black bag, which I need to wipe this little stain on there. Let's just ignore that. So kind of a good mix of handbags, one of each color, and then a cute little summery one to spice up looks. Moving on to shoes. Everyday basic pair of sandals. These are honestly so comfy and my go-tos. Then I have these here, which are, these are also super comfy. They're just like little slide-on flip-flops, but they have a cute little cross detail. Once again, kind of mixing up the colors. We have the brown, we have the black, so it's gonna mix well with everything. And then a pair of nude flats. So this looks a little disorderly, but I swear there is a method to my madness over here. The heavier items that I have here, if I do need to be layering, and then it sort of moves into other items. A jean jacket, I think this is perfect for summer, summer nights, cooler summer days. A blazer. I think you can never go wrong with a blazer in your wardrobe, and it's always gonna be that great layering piece. It makes your outfits look a lot sharper. And, you know, definitely something you can still rock in the summer with a pair of shorts. I picked this button up here because I do like how it has a little bit of a stripe on it, the subtle pinstripe, so it makes it a little bit different. It's cute, it's oversized, it's breezy. White button-up blouse. Another classic, very simple, boxy, striped long sleeve t-shirt. I think it's good to have a mix of sleeve length, so that's why I picked this one. My graphic t-shirt. I love having a graphic t-shirt in my wardrobe, and I feel like it definitely spices up your looks, so I picked this one out here, good for layering with the necklaces and all of the bottoms that I picked out as well. I cannot live without mock necks in my wardrobe, even in the summertime, so this is just like a deeper maroon red color, burgundy red, with the little mock neck and no sleeves. Basic white t-shirt, obviously. I also have just a simple white tank top here, just a very fitted white tank top. I have this black crop top here. I love to wear this with high-waisted items, so. And I also wanted to add a couple of like summery blouses, things to mix things up a little bit. So I have this little floral summer blouse. I thought that was really cute. Camisole top also has a little bit of a pattern on it. Picked 2 dresses. Number 1 being this orange slip dress kind of number with the lacy detail on it. A white dress. Dresses are also great because it is the one thing that makes up the whole outfit really. So if you put in a couple dresses or jumpsuits and things like that, you get more bang per wear, I guess. I was gonna say bang for your buck, but like, I don't know. You guys know what I mean. It's like you're getting more items in that 33. It's like a little tube top. I wore this so much last summer. I think it's so, so cute. So that one I really wanted to add. Next up, moving into the pants. So I have my wide leg green bottoms here, cream shorts. So I have them in cream. I also have these shorts in black. They're my favorite, so I did get them in a couple of colors. They're just really comfortable. Then I took a pair of my little DIY Bermuda shorts. Thought those would be great. Midi skirt, obviously. So I thought the leopard print midi skirt would be a good one. White denim that are cropped and a little bit frayed on the edge there too. So a pair of jeans, high-rise basic jeans. And these are full length. That's my 33 pieces. I'm really excited to do this, honestly. So definitely make sure you keep on watching because I'll do my little roundup at the end of the month. And also, if you want to follow me on Instagram, I will for sure be updating some outfits and posting some outfits on there with all of this goodness. I'm gonna wrap it up and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.